Hey, what's up guys? Theo Joe here, and today I'm gonna go over something I think most of you should enjoy, or at least those of you who use Android phones. I'm gonna go over a list of 10 different, not so well-known tips, tricks, and features in Android. And most of these should work with at least version 6 and later, but I'll probably tell you if that's not the case if I know. So anyway, why don't we just jump right in without further ado. First up is the hidden developers option menu, which isn't really too much of a secret these days, but I definitely couldn't leave it out. And this menu has all sorts of cool advanced settings not usually accessible, which we can get to some more of those in a bit. Now to access this menu, go to Settings, then go to About Phone, then you scroll down to where it says Build Number. Then you just keep tapping on the build number and it will start counting down until it says you are now a developer. After that, now when you go to the Settings app, there will be a new menu under System called Developer Options. In here, you'll find a whole bunch of new settings, some of which are absolutely useless to the average user, and some of them that aren't. So number 2 is specifically one of the more useful settings in here, and that is Animation Scale. If you scroll down in the Developer's Options, you'll see, well, really there's 3 options that control Animation Scale. There are 3 different ones, I'm gonna group them together, which control how fast or slow animations of the operating system are played. What this means, for example, is when you're opening an app, closing an app, transitioning through menus, all of that will be played either faster or slower. I personally have mine set to 0.5x, which means that each animation takes half as long or twice as fast. This makes the phone feel much more snappy since everything appears to respond faster, and you can also turn off animations altogether so there's no delay. However, sometimes with animations off, certain apps start to misbehave, so just be aware of that. And if for some reason you wanted, you could make animations slower, but be careful when setting it to 10x, because it will take forever to disable it again because you have to wait for really long animations now. Number 3, this one is really useful, I think at least, and it is the notification log widget. Let me ask you, have you ever had a notification pop up on your phone and you either swipe it away without thinking, or maybe it disappeared before you saw it and you think, oh no, what did it say? You didn't see it. Well, this will solve that. What you do is create a new widget by long pressing on the home screen, go to Widgets, and this might look a little bit different depending on what phone you have, and then you find the Settings shortcut and drag and drop it onto the home screen. Once you do that, it will show you a selection of different settings you can choose for that shortcut, and there are other ones you can look at later, but right now we're going to just choose Notification Log. In it, you can scroll through all your recent notifications, and it will show you a bunch of technical data for each one, including what the notification said, which is labeled as Android.txt. You can probably ignore everything else. I don't really know what all the other info is. You can probably figure it out though. And this is also really useful if the text of the notification is cut off, for example. Sometimes you see that and it won't show you what the whole thing says. This will show you that. So this is definitely one that I find really useful. I use it all the time. Next, number 4, offline Google Maps. What this lets you do is select a large area in Google Maps that will be downloaded and stored on your phone. The most obvious use of this is to download an area a few miles around your house where you live, which you'd presumably be driving around frequently. And this way, instead of having to download the map as you go every time when you're driving and using up data, you can just download a whole region at once while you're on Wi-Fi. You don't have to download it using cellular on the fly. This has 2 benefits. One, again, it will save you cellular data. And 2, it makes Google Maps faster since you don't have to wait for it to download anything every time. It's already all there. Also, it will automatically update the offline map when you're on Wi-Fi at home, so you're covered there. You don't have to worry about it being out of date. It doesn't take up too much space either, actually. The largest area you can download seems to be around 2 GB worth, but that will cover a huge part of your state probably, or even your country, I guess. It's a huge area. Okay, number 5, this one's kind of fun. It's the Android Easter Egg Game. Each version of Android seems to have a different one, but you can usually access them about the same way. You go to Settings, then look for About Phone, and then where it says Android version, you just tap on that a bunch of times and it should bring it up. In Android 7, which is what I'm using, it will bring up the Android 7 Nougat logo. And then from there, what you do is you tap on the logo a bunch of times really quickly and then long press it and hold it down. If it shows a no sign, it means you didn't tap it enough times. But if you did tap it enough times, it will show a cat emoji, which means you've activated the cat game. Now, if you go to quick settings by pulling down on the notifications window, then you go to Edit, there will be a new shortcut option for Android Easter Egg with a cat logo, which you can drag into the shortcut bar to access. And the game is pretty simple. You click on the dish and leave out food, and then every once in a while, a different cat will appear and show up. You'll get a notification, then you just collect the different cats, and that's it. It's kind of funny, but still cool. Number 6 is another pretty useful one. It's the hidden built-in file explorer. Most people think that you need a third-party app to browse through the phone's file system, but there is actually a basic one built in and already included. To get to it, you go to Settings, Storage, and then click the bottom Explore button. And there you are. You can now search for files, create new folders, copy and move files, delete them, and all that. You probably still need a third-party app to do anything advanced like network folders or something crazy like that, but this should cover all the basics. Moving on, number 7 is the System UI Tuner. This is another secret menu not enabled by default with some useful settings in it. Though keep in mind that not all phone manufacturer versions and skins might have it, so just keep that in mind. Now, to enable this, just pull down on the quick options, and you might have to do it twice, and then look for the wrench and gear at the top. Just press and hold on that until it animates or vibrates, and you'll probably know when that happens, and then that's it. Now, when you go to Settings, there will be a new menu called System UI Tuner with all sorts of options. One of these, for example, is to always show the battery percentage in the status bar so you don't have to guess about how much is left, which I'd consider essential. I don't know why that option isn't on by default, really. Then there's also Power Notification Controls, which lets you control which notifications different apps can show. Like, if there's an app that's really annoying, you can limit its notifications or block them altogether. And other options include enabling or disabling icons in the status bar, and even making the clock show seconds, not just hours and minutes. So there's a lot you can do in there. Next up, number 8 is to force apps to allow multi-window mode. In Android 7, you can now have the option to show multiple apps at once with this mode, but some apps don't allow it. However, you can force them to do so by going back to the developer options we enabled before and enabling the option called Force Activities to be resizable. Now, any apps that wouldn't allow multi-window mode before should, but keep in mind that they might act kind of weird because they don't technically support the feature, but some of them still might work. All right, almost near the end, number 9 is Data Saver Mode. There's actually two different kinds we're gonna talk about. The first one isn't really hidden, but it is disabled by default, and I think this one might only be available for Android 7, I'm not really sure. Now to get to it, you go to Settings, and then Data Usage, and then click Data Saver. This basically limits when apps can use data unless you specifically grant an app unrestricted data access. So enabling it seems to turn on Data Saver Mode for all apps, and then you would go in and individually disable it for some. And I think what it does is, like, if an app isn't right on the top of the screen, it won't allow it to use much data or something like that. Alternatively though, there is a way to enable another type of data saving mode in Google Chrome, because it's actually built into that. So if you go to Chrome, then Settings, you'll see an option for Data Saver, which compresses websites before loading them and setting them to your phone. And this actually seems to be a different thing altogether though, just because it's the same name, specifically for Chrome. So the Android Data Saver limits when any apps can use data, but the Chrome one compresses sites, so it reduces Chrome's usage, but you can enable both, I guess. All right, finally number 10, it's a neat little one you might not know about, Quick Battery Access. You probably already know that if you go into Settings, you can look at the battery stats, like usage over time, how much time is left, and all that. But there's actually a quicker way to see all that info. If you simply swipe down from the notifications bar, you can click on the battery icon, and that will show you most of the same thing. Obviously, you can see the percentage, but also how much estimated time is left, the battery usage graph again, and toggle the battery saver mode, probably the more useful thing here. So that will save you from having to do a few more clicks and from having to search through all the different settings to remember where the battery saver mode is. Pretty convenient. So that's it. Those are 10 of the features that I thought you guys would like to know about. I'm sure you've probably heard of some of them, but hopefully you at least learned something new. And if you guys have any suggestions though for features that I missed, definitely let us all know down in the comments. Maybe there's a super secret menu that no one's ever heard of before, I don't know. Or perhaps you're really smart and you already knew all of these, you can brag about it. Either way, if you guys did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you liked it, and let me know if you want to see more like this. And if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can click on those even if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And consider clicking the bell next to the subscribe button also, or else YouTube might not show you the new videos otherwise. So anyway, thanks again for watching, guys. And as usual, I'll see you next time. Have a good one.